Yeah, that was my plan. But it was plus maybe first a little bit, which is minus or plus, but by maybe 1 minute. So that was my plan.
Did that scare you more?
Yeah, first time it scared me because of 64 hours. And it was a little bit worried. But we reduced it a little bit and we set a pace with my pacemakers.
Go ahead.
Ruth, were you, was the goal just to get the world record, or were you really also shooting for the sub 2:10 time? Was your goal just to get the world record, or did you really want to run 2:09, like under 2:10?
My plan was 2:09, 2:10. And, that was my dream. And it has come true.
Ruth, was there a part of the race that was the most difficult for you today? Like, how did you feel at 25K and 30K, 35K? Did you feel still pretty good?
At around 25, I feel like it's a little bit tired, but when you set your mind and you focus, I think that's what I did. And
Ruth, how does it make you feel to have to be part of history now, to break a very historic barrier, be the first woman to have done that? How does that make you feel?
I'm much grateful. I'm feeling good. This is my dream has come true. I have waited for a long time, since 2022, when I missed by 47. And this 2024, I've made it.
Sure. Ruth, in last year's race, also started at a high pace. Did that experience from last year help you prepare your mind and body for today's effort? Last year's high pace at the start. Did that get you ready for going fast this year?
Since 2022, 2023, I think the first lap was faster.
Yeah.
But this year it was more faster than those years. But that one was my dream, yeah, my plan.
Ruth, did you talk to the pacemakers at all during the race, asking them to increase the pace or slow down? Did you have a conversation with them?
Yeah, when I see the pace was high, I was telling them to maintain or to slow a little bit. Yeah, that was a little bit.
Bruce, have you thought what's next for you? Have you given any thought to that, what you'll do after this, having set the world record here in Chicago? What do you think is in the future for you?
In the future, I don't know. Maybe private management, what next?
Ruth, whenever you run a marathon, you're almost always in the top three. I mean, you win most of them, but you're always in the top three. Except in London, you were only like seventh or eighth. What happened in London? Like, why weren't you your best in April? And what was better this time in the training? What happened in London?
In London, I was not in good shape. I had an injury in February. And I just trained for 1 month, 2 weeks. That was not enough for London. And I just do my best in London, yeah.
And what was the injury?
I had an ankle injury for both legs.
Ruth, can you describe your training? Do you train by yourself? on your hard runs, or what were you prepared for Chicago? Did you do most of your runs by yourself, or were you training with a group?
I have my pacemakers, and I was running my program with them, and we did it.
Okay, let me keep going.
Ruth, you just ran 2:09:56. That's incredible. Congratulations for the world record. How much faster do you think you can go?
2:09 was my plan. And I don't know in future if I will drop it. But nothing is impossible.
Do you think you put it in a place that's going to be very hard for other women to try to break that record? Is that what you wanted to do? To make it very difficult?
Yeah, to break a water body is not easy. It was a bare hand. Focus and determination. Yeah.
Ruth, who's your coach and how long have you been working with them?
Me as Ruth Chepngetich, I don't have a coach.
For a world record, sometimes they say the weather has to be perfect. It seemed perfect. There was very little wind. Did you have any problems with wind or the humidity? The wind blowing was very low?
The wind was not so strong. It was a little bit. The weather, the weather was
perfect, yeah. Ruth, with you coaching yourself, how did you study the sport? How did you study the marathon to coach yourself?
Since I started my career, I've never had a coach.
Ruth, you just pushed the boundaries for female marathoners. How do you hope to inspire young female runners back home?
Inspire them to be more, to be disciplined. Like their work, maybe follow their coaches, and I think by seeing a world record in women, I think they get motivated. That I think someone of maybe young generation in future, maybe they will try to.
Ruth, unfortunately, in recent years, there's been a number of doping positives in Kenya. What would you say to someone who says, when they see 2:09:56, just says, this is too good to be true, I have questions about it?
I don't have any idea.
Some people may think that the time is too fast and that you must be doping. What would you say to them?
Ruth, your training camp in Kenya is not too far from where Kelvin Kiptum would train, a little bit up on the hill more. Does it inspire you that now the both world record holders train in the same area? And did Kiptum's time inspire you to chase the records?
The place Kiptum was training was Kaptakat, but me training in Gong. It's far.
Oh, in Gong.
Yeah. But Kiptum inspired me to break the world record. Unfortunately, he passed away. And it was a sadness.
Ruth, did your manager give you any suggestions before the race? Any hints on how to run today? Did you talk with your manager about what you were going to do today?
To you to break the record, and what does it mean for your country?
My country, it means a lot. I'm proud of my country. The world record has come back there since pretty close there. And I'm proud of my country. Yeah.
Okay, we're going to have to wrap it up now and say thanks and congratulations.